Aid me. Be my eyes.
It's Eivor. Open the door.
Come in, but keep your voice down. You will alert Harald's men.
Where will we live?
The English will fight back!
Days ago, we rid this land of Kurtve and his dogs. Yet today, we do not celebrate. Today we cower under a cloud of fear. But it need not be like this. We are not the heel-trodden subjects of a boy king. We are the Raven Clan. Our destiny is our own.
Did you know about your father's oath to Harald?
I did not. And for that, my anger burns hotter than any man's here. But I will not let that drive me into despair. We cannot stay in Norway. Not under Harald's boot. Not without fueling more war. So we push forward. To newer lands. To England. And there make a new home. A kingdom of our own.
The sons of Ragnar Lothbrok have been in England 8 winters already. Is there any land left for a clan of our size?
More than enough, wife. Of the 4 kingdoms of England, only one is truly pacified.
I have no desire to wear Harald's leash. I like this idea.
A saga for the ages, I agree.
It will take time and resources to build ourselves a new home, but the riches taken from Kjotve's raid would suffice.
No. That belongs to my father, as a fair compensation. In England, we must start anew.
You would start us with nothing? In a land we do not know? Among people who hate us?
Kjotve's riches would go some way to easing our passage, Sigurd. I bested him. It is within my rights to claim his goods.
Our leaving must not be an assault on my father. It is a time of renewal for us.
If we go, we will need all the help we can get. I say we take Kjotve's spoils for our own.
I abhor such theft. But if this is what it takes to sway you to my cause, I accept.
Styrbjörn will prosper by the generosity of his new king. Kjotve's goods belong to us.
To England, then, before the day is out. Pack what you need, but no more than that.
And tighten your lips. The last thing we need is the attention of Harald's troops. How much did you hear?
Enough. A new path is revealed, and your journey will be challenging.
Will you not join us?
For my mother's sake, I cannot. But our threads will cross again before the final day. Until then, farewell.
I don't like the way those soldiers watch.
I find it flattering.
You think one will marry you when Kir...
Eivor, the wind favors us. We should set sail without delay.
You made quick work of packing. Well done.
The dream of new lands is a powerful lure.
As is the promise of glory. The act of leaving so beloved a home. There is a sadness to it.
Having doubts?
No. Not at all. The die is cast.
Then let fate guide our journey. Are you ready?
Not yet. I have a few things to settle first.
Make sure to bring me a beast!
Now, win your honor.
They are much bigger up close. I do not think I can do this. I do not think I can do this!
Come, Alan. Honor calls.
I did it! What an incredible fight!
You got a few stabs in.
How was your first kill?
Gods! I have never felt so alive! My Hooger soars on Raven's wings!
With this rebirth comes a new name. From this day, you will be called Erland Bearbane, Terror of the Caves.
Oh, it suits me. You know, now that I think about it, I think my story should be told in verse. Farewell, Beast Baiter.
Erland Bearbane, hear my name and quiver! Crawl back into your deep, dark caves, bear! Erland!
Stretch your wings, Sunan.
Have you come to face me, finally?
Are you the warlock who laid a curse on this land?
There was a curse here long before I came along. A curse of ignorance that infects all of Midgard.
So you're not using your magic against this land and its people?
I try to use my knowledge to help others. I am only a threat to those who fear the unknown, of which there are many.
There's a hunter who believes you poisoned his sister.
I tried to save her. I made a mixture that would have burned away her illness, but he chose to drench her in pig's blood. If there is any blame here, it lies on him and his ignorant kin. He killed his sister.
Do not listen. He will poison our thoughts.
You have no thoughts to poison.
Die, monster!
One day this land will be cleansed of these twisted deceivers.
I struck first, so I will claim the bounty. You may take what you wish from its carcass.
How strange.
One who wanders widely and has traveled far will learn the scope of mankind's nature and discover common sense.
Are you ready to set sail, Eivor?
I'm ready. Let us tank to the water and leave unbothered while we have the chance.
That chance has passed. Look!
Fate flies on swifter wings than we.
King Harald's banner.
Sigurd, what is this assembly? What are you planning?
An exit, father. As graceful as I can. For if I cannot be king in the land of my birth, I will start a new saga in England.
Nonsense. Your place is here, son, at my side. There will be other victories soon, other glories.
My choice is made, father. Do not hope otherwise. There's nothing for me here. I must go make my name in the world.
And you have plundered Fornberg's resources, I see. You leave nothing behind but your honor.
You left me no choice. I entered the Alving a prince. I left the son of a Jarl.
There are always choices, Sigurd. I will not stand between you and yours, but I do not accept it. 17 winters ago, I opened my door to you, Eivor. And now, your only thanks is to rob me? I should have left you to the wolves.
Sad old elk. Do not carry his words with you to England. He brought this day upon himself.
I know.
A time!
time for tears is over, you weeping sacks of wool! Put some muscle into those pools!
Ration your strength, dog. We have an ocean to cross.
All right, you lazy backrout. Sigurd, what's our course?
The Sons of Ragnar established a settlement near the coast. We set sail for that.
Bragi, sing a song to lift our hope.
To rouse the gods! Inspire a mighty fart from Thor to speed us on our way!
An ocean lies before us, Eivor. And on its far side, a new kingdom awaits.
You know England well from your travels.
I spent a season in their kingdom of Mercia, a temperate land, lush and wild. By now, the Sons of Ragnar will have claimed its heart.
Do we mean to join their army?
They will join ours. In time, all of England will know of Raegmund Clan and the glory he brought to that fractured land. So to England! Glory and destiny!
To England!
To England! For Valhalla!
In a lecture at the University of Cambridge, Dr. Sirka told a worried audience that scientists have few answers for them.
Since the mass coronal ejection of 2012, the strength of the Earth's magnetic field has increased by a factor of 50,000. This has resulted in huge disturbances in radio and satellite communications, dangerous bands of radiation around the poles, and as we can all see from our window, an aurora borealis that never burns away. Unfortunately, we are stumped as to why this is happening. And if we cannot find an answer soon, it may change the way we live, the way we communicate, even the way we evolve, forever.
Dr. Sirka went on to say...
Bought you more electrolytes? Oh, new and improved citrus flavor.
Thanks, Sean. How do we fix this? How are you the key to everything? You're a long way from home, Eivor.
rather walk into town than use this.
Another satellite. Damn.
Probably bought this in a coffee shop somewhere in Concord.
It's beautiful, but it's not normal.
Love to play around, but I have bigger things on my mind. Some quality stuff here.
Mint tea is not actually tea, Bex. It's an infusion. It's really just dirty, minty water.
I don't care what you call it, Sean. Did you buy any?
Of course I did, love.
Hey, sorry about pulling you out. The generator was sputtering.
That's fine. I needed air.
How is the Animus data stream? Comfortable?
Felt pretty stable after a while.
Good. Just give me a sec and you can jump back in.
Another satellite came down. Did you see?
I did. One of Abstergo's.
That's good.
Well, most of North America just lost its GPS service, so depends what you mean by good, really.
Right. Even when we win, we lose.
Okay, we're all set. Whenever you're ready, you can jump back in.
Hello, Layla.
Sean, what do you make of the grave out there?
Well, it overturns a few hundred years of scholarship about the first Europeans to set foot in North America. Apart from that, it's just a bunch of muddy bones, isn't it?
Can we talk about this thing on my neck for a second?
Ah, the mood stabilizer. Yes.
It's not harmful, is it? I mean, I feel good, but I want to make sure there's no side effects.
There shouldn't be. It's only blocking outside signals, a passive effect. So the staff doesn't, you know, mess with you.
Sean, what happened last year, I had no control over that. I tried to resist.
I understand. And your old team, maybe they don't. But we've seen that sort of thing before. Still, if you want to work with us and get to the bottom of why the world is about to end for the second time in 8 years, then you wear that thing until we say otherwise. William's orders.
I know. It's not a problem.
It's just a few more weeks, yeah? Just until we figure this out.
You're right. I know you're right. Sean has been busy. You mind if I put some music on?
Go for it.
Cool. You gonna put this in the fridge, Sean?
Of course. In half a minute.
Remember, tomatoes go on the counter, not the fridge. Please enjoy your stay. Remember, all the garbage must be packed out, and please water the plants once a day.
Yeah, I won't remember that.
Sean, don't forget to water the plants while I'm under, okay?
I'll add it to the calendar and tattoo it on my leg.
That's quite nice. Soothing. Let's have a look. Thank you.
might be interested in this. Conversations that Bex and I had with Desmond back in 2012. December, I think. Just, candid talks, that's all. We didn't square any circles or write any beat poetry. But he did have some interesting insights into his time in the Animus and what it means to be an assassin. Anyway, have a listen. You might find you and he had similar experiences, so, well, let me know what you think. Unless it's to tell me I sound like a total prat in these recordings. If that's the case, just say nothing. I mean, I did have a slight cold at the time I recorded these. That's probably why I sound odd. Anyway, okay, I'm done anyway, so turn off. Turn off. Oh, it's actually just a button. Sorry, here we go.
No, no, come on, Sean. Turn that thing off.
Oh, hold on. I like what you said there. I want to get this for posterity. Say it again, nice and loud.
Seriously?
Sure, come on. If nothing else, it'll give me leverage with your old man.
Ah, that's your angle. Nice. What I said was, I wish I hadn't been born into the Assassins. I wish I had chosen this life. Is that good enough?
Sure, but why is that?
Because choice is the central idea of our creed. It underpins everything, right? It's about free will. It's about seeing the evidence before you and saying, yes, this is what I want. Or, no, this isn't for me. But when you're born into a group like this, or any other, like I was, you get mixed signals. You get told over and over again, this is what we believe. These are the rules. This is reality. No deviation. And if you question it, oh, they look at you like you killed a puppy. That's hardly free will. It's a weird irony when free will is your central belief, but nobody wants you to believe otherwise. I don't know how to say it exactly, but I always thought there was something self-destructive about our creed. If free will is the most important moral guidepost we have, we should be free to ignore it, to choose submission, for example. You know what I mean? Like, we should be free to side with the Templars. If it's really my choice, I could do that.
Right. It's almost self-refuting. A democracy could democratically elect a dictator or choose to get rid of democracy altogether. Within our creed is the seed of its own destruction. That's what makes it powerful, I think. And fragile.
Right, right. The more freedom you have, the more risky it is, you know? Anyway, my dad has mellowed over the years, but he was strict when we lived on the farm. He ran a tight ship. I never got the impression that I was free to choose my path forward. Our creed, our tenets, they were drilled into my head. By the time I was a teenager, I was following these rules out of a sense of duty. This was just what we did.
That happens to a lot of organizations over time. A stagnation sets in, you know? A fundamentalism.
Yeah. Following the rules becomes more important than achieving whatever goal you set out for yourself. And people start to lose sight of the reason the rules exist.
That's called deontology, or a form of it. Following a rule for its own sake and not for the consequences it has.
Yeah, but that feels backwards, doesn't it?
Well, I think so. Following a rule is the easy part. Praying, taking a sip of wine, munching on a wafer. Rituals that give comfort.
But that's just going through the motions. It makes people feel like they're doing something. When the hard work is, well, actually getting off your ass and doing something productive. I think people just want boundaries. Tight boundaries. They want to see the four walls that pen them in.
I don't disagree.
Anything outside that, anything that makes life more complex, that's scary. That's why I envy you. You chose this life. You went through that process, and you decided, yes, I believe in this.
Sure. It didn't stop me from being an insufferable know-it-all as a teenager, but I see your point.
I would have loved to have been a know-it-all. I knew nothing. Not until you guys found me. Yeah. It wasn't until I met you, and Bex, and Lucy, that I knew. I knew I wanted to be an assassin.
Oh, thanks, Des. Come here. Bring it in, bud. I don't normally like touching, but I'll make an exception now.
I am not hugging you.
You sure?
because I smell very nice today. Can you just turn that off?
Hold on, I'll just set this here.
Do you guys record everything we talk about?
Not everything, but you've been using the Animus so much, I thought this was a good chance to learn some things about prolonged exposure.
So I'm your guinea pig?
No, my guinea pigs are all dead. The Animus was too much for them to handle.
Cute.
Can I ask you about the bleeding effect? Any recent flashes? Any memories resurfacing?
Yeah, the usual things. Ghost images of Altair and Ezio a few times a day. Nothing intrusive, just brief moments. They pass quickly, almost without me noticing. Like a figure in the corner of my eye, or remembering a dream from the night before. I did have one extended hallucination a few days ago. It was Ezio. He was older, around the time he left Cappadocia. He was standing on the deck of a ship, alone. And through him, I could feel an intense regret or guilt. And it felt to me like he'd had a loss of faith in himself, in the creed, like he couldn't keep it up, couldn't stay true to his ideals. And as I watched him, I thought, is this the moment he decided he was done being an assassin? It felt like it. Anyway, most of my visions have been brief, lasting just a few seconds. They're like complete memories of small moments that appear suddenly out of nowhere, fully formed. It's a strange feeling.
Okay, anything else?
I'm starting to see Connor now, too. Though I hear his voice more often than I see him. I'm sure that will change. Oh, yeah, and yesterday, just before bed, I had a memory of being on a beach in the Caribbean with a bunch of sailors. Or maybe they were pirates. I don't know. No idea.
Huh. We'll look into that. And how do you feel in general?
In general? Well, I feel older, for one. Much older. And it's strangely comforting. I'm collecting the memories and skills and thoughts of so many people. I feel like I've lived a few hundred years or more. Is it possible that if I do this for too long, it'll push my own memories aside? That I'll be everyone but myself after a while?
It's possible. That's called identity substitution. It's happened before, but it's rare. And someone with your background shouldn't need to worry.
My background? You mean someone with my genes? My abilities?
You have Isu DNA, and that lets you see things and do things and withstand traumas that other people can't.
And I can suffer in ways that others can't. That's not something to be proud of.
You mean the apple?
Yeah. It has a pull, Bex. It tugs at my brain. It talks to me. Teases me. Drives me mad. And what I did to Lucy. God damn it. Nothing is worth the damage I did. The pain I caused.
I know. But you're special. That's the point.
I'm not special, Bex. I'm lucky. That's all.
I understand.
We're assassins. It's our creed that makes us different, not our genes, not our blood. Anyone can join us.
That's true. But let's leave that aside for a second. What I want to know is, have you ever had any Isu memories resurface?
Isu memories? I don't think so. I can't even begin to imagine what that would feel like.
I think you'd know if you did. Maybe one day. We might be able to induce something.
Jesus, let's fix the world first, okay? Before we start digging up my ancient ancestors.
Deal.
With my luck, I'll be related to some third-rate Isu like Sisyphus or something.
Way to aim high, buddy.
Hey, you gotta.
I went through hell to bring you here. It had better be worth it. I should do this more often. Relaxing.
Feeling okay?
Better. But I'm worried that it could happen again. The two data streams.
I can't promise it won't. I barely understand it myself.
It felt like two minds fighting over one brain. It hurt like a shotgun to the head.
Right. There's something about this Viking's DNA sample that feels dense, noisy.
Could it be the staff? Interfering somehow?
How do you mean?
My headaches, my temper. They started the day I got that thing.
I hope you're not making excuses for, you know, your friend.
Jesus, no. I'm not.
Sorry. Just take it easy. And if you feel yourself slipping again, let us know.
I'm trying. I really am. Be nice to sleep in a real bed when this is over.
All right, time to go. Norway to England takes about a week by long ship, so I'll scrub ahead. Layla, you okay?
Sorry. Can you play the message again?
We have the transcript. If you're looking for something, I can go and...
No, I want to hear it.
Okay.
I don't mean to be cryptic. It's just... That message led us here. To this place. To a Norse grave in North America. So those bones out there are the only lead we have. Our only chance at fixing this planet before it's too late.
Here it is.
I lived. I died. And now I sleep. And in my sleep, I dream. And in my dreams, I see an end to the doom that will grip the Earth once again. Find the Wolfkist. Find the Mad One. Find me. And save us all from another death.
Unsettling, that is.
That pulse in the message. Are you sure it's just coordinates? Nothing else?
Nothing I can find.
Okay, I'm ready.
Here we go.
Not a patch on Norway, but we'll make this land our own soon enough.
I'm glad to see any land. And at all. I will be happy to have my feet on solid ground again.
We must not rush our landing. All you see here is Saxon territory. The Kingdom of Mercia, largely unpacified. There will be eyes watching us from the trees, with bows drawn and traps set. We must be wary. Randi, dig in your oars! All standing!
Have you spotted something?
Not yet. Well, let us go ahead to clear the path of any dangers. Then follow our lead when the sun brushes the horizon.
Understood! May Thor bless you all on your way! We will see you soon!
Sail on!
Yes! I'm ready for whatever these green-thumbed fairy folk have to throw at us!
Sigurd, do the sons of Ragnar know that we're coming?
They do not, but they will not scoff at our visit. Of the four kingdoms in England, the sons of Ragnar have settled only one. The rest is ripe for the taking.
Do we mean to join their army?
No. No. We will speak with them. Get the lay of the land. And carve this country into as many pieces as we see fit.
Look ahead there! Is that what passes for a town? Plain brick and a single rune to their timid god?
That rune is called a root, Dag. The cross upon which their god was sacrificed. It sits atop a monastery, a place of worship.
That cross killed their Christ, and now they display it in worship? Bizarre!
We carve idols of our gods and make wishes before them, like our sacrifices to Odin, the One-Eyed.
But we do not worship the wolf that kills him! That is the difference!
Whatever strangeness we see in these Saxons, they must think the same of us.
The hammer! Now there is a symbol worthy of a god. A bolt of lightning would take that cross clean off! Look there! What are they doing?
Ritual drowning.
Baptism, Dag. Are the ways of Christians really so unfamiliar to you?
Not at all. I simply forgot. And someone has to keep the conversation up. It must be priests and worshippers alone in that place. We could storm this port with ease. Sack it without breaking a sweat.
Is there much in the way of treasure there?
Always! They shape precious metals and cup jewels to their gods. There will be a fortune there.
Later, Dag. There will be time enough for raiding, once we have settled. Come to, stop the boats! Pull up over there! The way forward is blocked by a chain spanning the river. We must remove it before passing on.
A chain? Can we cut through it?
It's too thick for access. But there must be a way to release it, somewhere in that camp.
I will go.
and I will be right behind you.
No, Dad. You stay here. Should trouble come our way, I want you defending the ship.
A good idea. Send out the arrow and keep your sharpest axe at hand, huh?
Something like that.
Show me what lies ahead. I should not be seen in this area. This chain is huge, and poorly anchored, it appears. I might be able to shoot it.
Sigrid!
back, Sigurd. Give those dogs a good knock around and take whatever treasures they have. Easy pickings.
Not today, Dad. We press on until we reach our goal. We cannot afford another surprise. Now be on your guard. It should not be far.
Gods, I'm ravenous. I hope they have food and ale on hand when we arrive. You should have sent word ahead of us, Sigurd, to get something on the spit.
If Halfdan, Ubba and Ivar Ragnarsson are lacking food in England, then all of us will starve. Have no worry.
Ah, I can see it now. A suckling pig, tender and juicy, and ale as gold as the treasures that we failed to steal back there.
A man of simple pleasures, aren't you, Dad?
And he is happier for it. For my part, I look forward to standing in the footsteps of the giants that built this land.
What giants?
The great Romans and their empire. Giants of a forgotten age. They held dominion here long ago, and their ruins dot the landscape. Every brick and stone tells a story of conquest and glory. And now, they are rubble and ash.
Ready to be remade. We will rebuild their empire, brick by brick. And ours will not crumble to dust.
All things end, dog. The ruins are not a warning. They're a testament. Look there, just ahead. Where the sons of Ragnar make their camp.
At last, we find our feet on steady ground.
Sigurd, hold back. Something isn't right.
Good eye. There's too little movement for an army. Only tents and a few men.
Not the army we hoped to find.
No. Let us get a closer look.
Those are not Norsemen. They're too rapid and soiled.
We should proceed on foot, lest they spot the boats.
Dag and I will go together.
We all go. If they are friends, I wish to meet them as a jarl. And if they are foes, then we fight them all together. Who are these men?
They speak with twisted accents. English, no doubt.
Dag, Eivor! On me!
What's this? A mess of filthy Danes befouling our riverways?
You there. Give us your name.
I am Sigurd Jarl of Fornberg. And you are?
Men who do not take kindly to Dane invaders creeping into our camp. You'd best move along, pagan. Spare yourselves a slaughter.
You threaten Norsemen with a play of swords and expect us to cower?
I have been 8 days at sea without a drop of blood to wet my axe. So spare the chatter, Buckrout, and draw your weapon.
Oh!
Your pig feet!
Let's finish them!
Kill these demon bastards!
Trolls take you!
Right. I'll check the longhouse.
I think this is clear. What do you say, Darlene?
Agreed. All clear.
Aid me. Be my eyes.
Wait! Who are you? Are you with those brigands as well?
Sigurd! Dag! In here! Those men had prisoners.
You there! Untie us! Let us walk and we will not hurt you!
Quite bold in those bindings. I like your spirit.
We are very agreeable people, I promise. You need not kill us.
Peace, friend. We have no need or wish to hurt you. What are your names?
Yenli. I'm a merchant, not a bandit like those others. And this is Rowan.
Rowan, that's right. I'm a stable hand, that's all. I keep horses and, well, I did, till those brigands sold them off.
They meant to sell us next, as slaves to the nearest bidder. But I ripped their eyes out before I let that happen.
And how did you find yourselves here?
We came to trade with the Sons of Ragnar, at Halfdan Jarl's asking. But they were gone when we arrived.
Unbind them. You know the Sons of Ragnar?
Aye. Sold many a mare and stallion to the brothers. Good men. Always paid me fair.
From the look of this camp, they've been gone for some time. Where will you go now? What will you do?
Rebuild my stocks? Start anew? I have friends and allies across the land to aid me, but it won't be easy.
Every town and village needs a stable to keep horses fit and trim. I'll find my footing again, somewhere.
What are you thinking?
That we could use their skills as we get settled. Having access to trade and someone to tend our mounts would be a boon.
My thoughts as well. Any friend of the Ragnarsons is a friend of mine. Right, Dag?
Whatever you think is best, Sigurd.
Yanli, Rowan, I am Sigurd Jarl of Thornberg, son of Styrbjörn. This is Eivor and Dag. Both of you are free to go, but more than welcome to stay if you're willing to pull your weight.
We'd be happy to, if only to get back on our feet.
Then let it be done. The Raven Clan welcomes you. From strangers into friends into family. The others have arrived. Come.
I have a good feeling about this place.
Honored family, friends, welcome to your new home. Fine work. A longhouse to rival any I've seen. Now come. Randvi has found something I would like you to see.
Eivor, Sigurd, I give you England and its four kingdoms. Mercia, East Anglia, Northumbria, and Wessex. From the few plans and maps I discovered here, I believe the Sons of Ragnar have pushed further into Mercia, here. My scouts will soon tell me if I am correct.
And where are we?
Here, in this unnamed copse of trees.
Unnamed? We cannot let that stand. What will we call this place?
I might have an idea.
Ravensthorpe. The village of ravens.
I like it. The poet in you sings once again. One day this name will be known throughout all of England.
A name is only a beginning. If we want renown, we must build. Expand.
Agreed. We should begin with a forge. Can you help Gunnar get working again?
We'll need cargo, supplies.
For that our neighbors will provide, whether they wish to or not.
Scarcely arrived, and now we must raid.
We cannot master this land merely by asking.
I'll go and speak with Gunnar now.
Good work, my dear. And what else have you found?
Short notes, mostly. Scraps of plans, old records, a few runes thrown there.
Thank you.
Not a bad place, Eivor. Not at all.
Can I help you with anything?
Sigurd wants your forge up and running as soon as possible. For that, we need supplies and riches.
Ah, you mean to go a Viking then? Good, good. How I miss those days. Ransacking and pillaging. Blade singing and shield splintering.
I would ask you to join us, but you are the only blacksmith we have. We cannot afford your loss.
Oh, it's no bother. Better I forge axes than swing them. My place is here, not pulling on the oar of a river horse. Though you do remind me, I've found a map among the bandits' rubbish, marked up with the locations of Saxon monk huts.
Yes. Bandits know as well as we do. Monasteries are full of riches and loot.
Take the map with you, and put it to better use than they did.
I should be cautious around here.
At least I got a trophy out of that.
Guards here are vigilant.
Don't think I'm high enough.
Yeah.
God dang it.
Best not to draw attention here. Must be blocked from the other side. Stretch your wings, Sunan.
His entrance.
Stay away from me!
Damn you!
Oh, damn, snakes.
Now you pay!
God loves me!
This area is off limits.
out much longer.
Side must be barred.
Side.
Fast.
Survey the area, Sunan.
For favor you, my friend.
Vikingar! Play!
Be gentle if they spot me.
Thank you. Hey, you want some meat?
This way, huh? All right.
Sorry, the ale is all gone.
Ah! Where's my meat? Shreddery, Ailey.
Itaque motoromque Christi fidelium explentes.
Precinct freaks of empty barrels
and... Sinistra tristis terram atque.
Sobriety.
Inuc vagabantur incerti sum dies et noctes. In terra quorum domino quiam...
And Suaros here was it? You make
the... Beer! This way.
Oh, I'll follow you then.
Yes, I've run out of meat.
A beer! Bring me beer, now! Ah, don't feed you sweet ale! What may you call?
There's no need for this.
Well, aren't you a fine tulip?
Thank you.
Bend your ears and listen all. For the good of our clan, it is time we go a Viking. Today we raid, and tomorrow we may build.
Here now. The monasteries will be well guarded.
More than priests and friars, I'd wager.
Sail is ready when needed.
Run up the sail. Help me out here!
Try to flank!
God damn it. I need to work on my rations more.
Monastery there, Eivor!
Thank you.
My thanks, Eivor.
Hey, come here a moment.
Take your life. Thor lends me strength. This was a good day, and some fine work from all of you. We should return home and unload everything.
Are you certain there aren't a few more gold nuggets squirreled away somewhere?
My gut tells me no.
So, Eivor, what's your count?
My count? Dag, I've no need to count my kills. They number too many.
Likely story, Wolfkin.
That's the same.
I killed 26, I think.
Nah, there were barely a dozen when we arrived, Dag.
No, no, you missed them. They attacked from the forest.
Hold here.
Hearken well.
Save it.
back so soon. And with good news, I hope. This is wonderful, Eivor. A forge bigger and harder than my old forge back in Fornberg. Come visit me anytime. For weapons and gear, there is no man better than me.
I will, Gunnar. Have no doubt.
The gods are smiling on us.
Can you remind me what you do here?
If you need weapons and armor enhanced or adorned, that's what I'm here for.
I would like to see what you have in stock.
Ready for battle.
I have to go. See you soon.
Be well, my friend.